So what's the title of this article?
Master on the Mound.
As a good reader, you automatically think strategically and actively to understand what you read. As a tutor, your challenge is to learn specific reading comprehension strategies to teach explicitly, one at a time, to your learner. By learning comprehension strategies, your learner will become aware of how to think in order to make meaning while reading. Skimming is a comprehension strategy that helps readers get to know a text without reading it thoroughly. Good readers skim texts automatically, but struggling readers must be explicitly taught the steps involved in skimming, such as reading the title, subtitles, and headings, looking at illustrations, reading the first and last sentence of each paragraph, looking for key words, and thinking about the text's meaning.
So, Simone, we're going to be continuing in our skimming activities because you can use skimming in so many different ways. And so we have talked about some really sort of down and dirty, fast ways to skim. So now we're going to do a little bit more formal strategy for skimming. So I've actually typed out for you a 5-step strategy for how to skim a text. And so a strategy, you know, really is a tool that has step-by-step pieces. It breaks it down so that you can remember, okay, did I do step one? Okay, great, I did that. Now I'm ready to go to step two. I did step two. Now I'm ready to go to step three. So that you always have this sort of, you know, list of, did I do it? Did I do it? Did I do it? Yes, I've done it all. Now I know my strategy is complete. And so you can check yourself and whether you are completing the activity correctly. This is all, again, about comprehension. So skimming is a comprehension tool. And so when you want to check your own understanding of something that you're reading, you might want to use these 5 steps for skimming to say, did I follow all of these steps to allow me to skim the text? So you're skimming either to just to get the general idea, and then you leave it at that, or you get the general idea, and that allows you then to go deeper. Say, you know what? I want to read more about this particular area. Okay. So I know that you are a big sports fan.
Yes, I am.
And that you really like the sports pages.
Yes.
So we're going to work with the sports page today.
All right, okay.
And so we're going to do another skimming activity with the sports page. And so again, in our other activities, I've just kind of asked you to look for keywords. I've asked you to run your eyes over the text. And that was sort of a good enough strategy for skimming for the purposes of that. But for this activity, we want to be a little more formal. We want to be a little more intentional, or we want to be a little more focused and sort of step by step.
Okay.
And so we're going to use this 5-step process.
Okay.
So the first step is what? Can you read what the first step?
Read the title, script list.
Subtitles?
Subtitles and headings to find what the text is about.
Let's actually read through all 5 steps and then we'll go and we'll do each one. So what's step number 2?
Look at the illustrations for future information about the topic.
For further information about the topic, good.
Read the first and last sentence of each paragraph.
Okay,
step
4?
Step 4 is don't read every word or every sentence. Let your eyes skim over the text, taking in the keywords.
Good. And step 5, the last one?
Think more about the meaning of the text.
Okay, yeah, that's when you sit back, you've done all your steps, and you're like, okay, now what does this mean? Okay, this is when you really, you know, focus on that comprehension.
You've just seen a learner and a tutor practicing skimming strategies to help the learner understand the gist of the text. You can use this strategy with a variety of texts for several different purposes, depending on your learner's interests and needs. The goal of practicing reading comprehension is for your learner to master and internalize more and more comprehension strategies to choose from and use in a variety of reading situations. You've seen a tutor do quite a bit of talking when explaining a new strategy. During most lessons, you and your learner would be equally talkative.